Hey you guys, welcome back. This week is going to be a little bit different, so I'm only uploading one video for the entire week, and you still will have three assignments. All three assignments are quizzes, and the links are going to be under this video. It's all over last week's content, so please just review your notes from last week. We're talking about animal traits and behaviors, and you're just gonna go through a couple examples similar to the quizzes we did last week. The reason why we're doing it this way is because we want to free up your time and our time to help you guys get registered for next school year. So if you are registered already, perfect. You're going to get an incentive from me. If you're not registered, you have this week to work on it. And if you get your parents to show your homeroom teacher that they have completed registration, then you will get a free pass for Friday's assignment. So what I mean by that is you have quizzes 1, 2, and 3 for this week. You're only gonna have to do 2 quizzes if you complete your registration. As always, if you need any help at all with the assignments or with registration, we're available by phone to walk you step by step through the whole process. We just want to make sure you guys are ready to go for next school year, and I wanted to make it a little bit easier on you. So I hope that you have an amazing week. I hope to hear from you soon.
Hello guys, this week for science we're doing a little something different. So you are going to only have one video like I mentioned in math. So all you have to do for all Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays lessons, which are going to be lesson 17, 18, and 19, is just look at this video that you're going to be getting on Monday today. So we are continuing with traits. Vamos a continuar con los rasgos de animales y plantas, y nomás solamente vamos a tener un video para toda la semana. Las lecciones van a ser lección 17, 18 y 19, y también van a tener que tener una prueba en quizzes. So make sure that you take your quiz for each lesson, and I expect everyone to participate. I want to have 100% participation rate, guys, okay? So y'all have a good week and try to get it all done.
Hey guys, the word of the week is registration. So this week, your job is to get registered for middle school. If you in my homeroom, if you registered by Friday, or if you already registered, you're gonna there's going to be a drawing for a special prize. I'm gonna pick a random name from all of the people that have registered. If you're not going to be in a school from the district, like if you're going to a charter school or whatever that may be, you have to let me know so that I can tell administration that you're not going to be here next year. If your parents need absolutely any help with the registering or where to go or how to even get started, just have them text me. But you guys have to get that registration done this week. So please, please, please let your parents know that you want the chance to win the cool prize. This week, there's not going to be 3 videos. This is the only video for this week. All 3 assignments for the whole week are on the description from this video. So on today, just take the Monday quiz. Remember that I get a notification when you take the quiz, so I'll know if you try to do all 3 quizzes today. So only the Monday quiz do today, and then on Wednesday do the Wednesday quiz, and on Friday do the Friday quiz. If you're one of those people that tries to do all 3 quizzes, I'm gonna get a notification, and I'm gonna know that you didn't follow directions and that you tried to do all three quizzes, and I'm only gonna count, give you grade for the quiz that you did on Monday. So no three videos, all three quizzes for the rest of the week are in the description down below. I am going to focus this week on helping your parents register if they need it. So that's it. All right, so now let's go ahead and see who won the large pizza that's going to be delivered to their house on today on Monday. So I'm gonna text you by 4 o'clock to make sure that you guys, that the person that won saw this video. And I'll get in touch with you. Remember, they have you have to take a picture of you with the pizza so that we can show everybody who won. So congratulations to whoever it's going to be. Let's go ahead and see. Okay, so I went to this website where you can just write everybody's name, and I put it there, and I spin this wheel, and it's gonna choose someone randomly. Who is it going to be? Adolf or Toby? It is Toby. Congratulations, Toby. So I'm gonna text your mom. Congratulations, Toby. So the list of that, the people on that wheel, it was the people that have missed consistently, have gotten 100 or just missed one question on their quizzes. Again, if you're in my homeroom on Friday, I am going to raffle another pizza delivery for the people that finish registration. So if you're one of those people that have already registered for middle school, or gets your registration done by Friday and I get that list and you're on there, you get another chance to win. All right, guys, have a great week. You guys are amazing. Remember to tell your parents to let me know if they need any help. And that's for anybody that sees this video from all homerooms. If you know, you're there and your homeroom teacher is not available at that time, just go ahead and text me. We'll try to figure it out. We'll see you guys next week.
Hello, guys. This week is going to be a little different. You're only going to get one video for the entire week. So you're going to have all three math lessons on one video. Okay? Que todos los videos, los tres para los tres días, lunes, miércoles y viernes, van a estar en un video. So you're going to need to be only looking at one video for the entire week. So the entire work is going to be on one video. How many videos? Only one. So look for the sheets that have Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. Those are your assignments. Now, you don't have to wait until Wednesday and Friday to do Wednesday's work or Friday's work. If you want, you can do all the work Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday and not do anything Thursday and Friday. Okay? What y'all want to do, it's fine with me. But remember, only one video. Okay, guys. Here is your Monday's work. So, for Monday, May 4th, you're going to be adding fractions. I put adding and I'm subtracting, but you're just going to be adding fractions. So I did the first one here for you. 4/5 plus 1/2. Well, you see how they have different denominators? You have got to come up with your common denominator. So find your LCM, the least common multiple. So 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 5, 10, 15, 10, and 10, that's going to be your new denominator. So whatever you do to the 2 to get a 10, that's what you're going to multiply the 1 by to get your numerator. What did you do to the 5 to get 10? Well, you're going to need to multiply the same thing to the numerator and get your new numerator, and then add. Now, if you come up with an improper fraction, you've got to divide to get a mixed number. Okay, so here are the rest of the problems. And you shouldn't have any problems. For Wednesday's work, you're subtracting fractions. Why? Because we need more practice. So when you have different denominators, you gotta find your LCM, your least common multiple. So there's your example for number one. Here's problem number two. Here's number three. Number four. And number five. So, only 5 problems for the entire day, guys. And remember, y'all need to be able to do this before you get to middle school. So that's why we are subtracting fractions on Wednesday. Actually, you only got 4 problems because I did the first one for you.
And for Friday, you're going to have three addition fraction problems, two order of operations. I did number four. I gave you the steps. So it's very similar to number five. Got to get this down. And then for six, seven, and eight, the last three problems, you are going to be subtracting. So remember, all of this is review. And the reason we're doing a review is because it's a special week. We're only going to give you one video for all three lessons. So we decided to put them all together in just one video. So here's your Friday's assignment. One, two, and three, adding fractions. Four and five, order of operations. Six, seven, and eight, subtracting fractions. Good luck, guys.
Hey Griffins, happy Monday. So this week is gonna be a little bit different. As Ms. Broberg said, this is the only video that you're going to watch this week. And for reading, what you're gonna do is I'm going to assign you one full passage. It's not gonna be a small one like we've been doing, or a short one, I'm sorry. And you're gonna have a total of 9 questions. So you're gonna split those 9, the smart thing to do is to split those 9 questions amongst the Monday, Wednesday, Friday. So what you're gonna do is Monday, work on 1 through 3. Wednesday, work on 4, 5, and 6. And then Friday, work on 7, 8, and 9. Now you're only going to have one quizzes link below for reading. And that's because I'm going to count the whole thing as one grade instead of 3 grades. So on Monday, if you do 1, 2, and 3, do not click on the quizzes link, because then you're not gonna know 4 through 9, okay? So again, if you choose to do maybe 4 a day, oh, I wanna do 4, and then I wanna do another 4, and then the 1, or however you choose to split it up is up to you. However, the easiest way I would say is Monday do 3 questions, Wednesday 3 questions, Friday 3 questions, and then submit all 9 questions on quizzes. It's one quiz. Okay, as Ms. Broberg said, we want you all working on registration. If your parents, I know half of my homeroom class has completed it. I contacted your parents on Friday and told them if they need any help to let me know. And I got, I think 3 people responded. So if your parents need help with registration, go ahead and click on the link below. And there's some videos that I also sent to your parents so that they can get started on that. So if your parents are, if you show your homeroom teacher that you have completed registration, then I will be giving you extra credit on this quiz, okay? So again, one passage, 9 questions for the entire week. This is the only video. And I'm gonna go ahead and on this video is also going to be the passage, because I know some of you maybe don't have your book on you. So I'm going to, after this, post the passage and then the questions so that you can refer to them. But you are going to read all questions and answer choices on your own this week, okay? Miss you guys. I hope you have a wonderful week. So this week's story is under the same learning target that we talked about last week. We will be able to explain the author's purpose and message within a text, and also analyze how the use of text structure contributes to the author's purpose. Your story starts on page 282, and it continues on 283. Of course, make sure you do RNAG RQPC. Here are your first 4 questions. Again, you may choose how you split up the work, but there is only going to be one link at the end. Your last question, number 9, will be an open-ended question. So you're gonna have to type in the answer, but if I were you, I'd think about it and write it down in my book before I take the quiz. So number 9 says, what is the author's message in the text? Use evidence from the text to support your answer. So 1, tell me what the author's message is, and 2, how do you know? Okay, you're not gonna worry about number 10. You're only doing 1 through 9. Just a reminder, it's gonna be 1 quiz per reading, and do not take it until you have completed 1 through 9. Have a wonderful week, boys and girls.